So we've kind of accepted that this guy is the daddy, right? That this guy really, really, really wins.
Yeah.
So it got me thinking about this number. And I'm now going to sort of indulge in a little bit of philosophy just for... And it's open that it's, I'm going to put it out there for debate. I want to ask whether this number exists. Now, I know you've done videos about, you know, whether numbers exist or not. Okay. So I guess I'm thinking more in the... In the nominalist sense, does this guy exist in any kind of physical way? Does it have physical existence, this tree of Graham? And actually, you could probably apply this logic to Graham's number itself, or even tree three. But certainly something as big and as you know, a beast like this, right? Okay, does it really exist in physics, in the physical world, in any sort of reasonable sense? There's no definite answer to this, but I think I'm going to hazard my opinion on it. Okay. I'm going to say no. And the reason is the following. So we know that we live in a universe which has a very, 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 very small but positive vacuum energy. So it has the vacuum itself carries a little bit of energy. Okay, and what this does to our universe is it means we're surrounded by a very, very large sphere, which is like a horizon. And it's large, but it's finite. And one of the things about that is that means that there's only about a finite number of degrees of freedom, a finite number of building blocks, which you can use to describe the physics of our universe. So if I think about a number like Tree of Graham, how do I measure whether there's Tree of Graham things or Tree of Graham of something? Well, I can think about data, right? Can I have Tree of Graham bits of data? Is that even possible? Again, so the answer to that is no, because of this cap that nature is putting on us. Because of this, the fact that we are surrounded by this finite horizon, okay, there's actually a storage limit in our universe that you cannot go beyond. Okay, and it's much, much less than this number. So if you think, like, you know, you've got your laptop, if you start downloading too many videos or something, right, you're eventually going to run out of storage capacity. Well, it's the same with the universe. If you want to try to get up to this number of bits of data, it's just not possible. The universe says no. That exceeds the storage capacity of our universe. It's not there. It can't happen. So then we can beg. So I think there's no way that this can ever exist in our universe.
We can only imagine it.
We can conceive it. Yes, we can conceive it.
We can imagine what that laptop would be like that could have one more video on it. But
exactly, we can imagine. We can imagine what it would be like to have, you know, $350 million for the £350 million for the NHS if in the event of Brexit. But it's not going to happen, right? Okay. So I think this guy can't exist in our universe. So then you could ask the question: well, what could I change about the universe to make it exist? Could there be a kind of universe where you could have this sort of thing as a real thing? And there are three things I think you could do to change that. I think the first one is you just have to grow the universe. You have to make that horizon bigger. That means bringing the vacuum energy down a bit. So you have to make the horizon bigger. It has to get really, really big. Okay. As it gets bigger, you're allowed more. The storage capacity goes up. You're allowed more and more data. So maybe you could go past this number. The other thing that puts a cap on this, there's two more things. The other thing is gravity, okay? This storage limit comes from the physics of, partly from black holes, for example, okay? And if you weaken gravity, if you make gravity really, really, really weak, if you do away with gravity altogether, again, the storage limit will go up, okay? So that's another way. So you could just really start to tune down gravity to essentially nothing. So gravity is stupidly weak, and then the storage capacity could go up. The third thing you could do is you could do away with quantum mechanics. Because again, this is quantum mechanics, in a sense, give us the basic building blocks. And if you start taking Planck's constant to zero, again, this storage capacity goes up. So then you can say, well, are any of those compatible with life that can actually ask the question whether this thing exists? So if I start with quantum mechanics, I don't think so. I think if you start to try to do away with quantum mechanics, for example, it guarantees the stability of the atom, right? So if you start doing away with quantum mechanics, then how is the atom stable? How can you build molecules? How can you build the complexity you need for life? I can't really see how you could do that. You would definitely need something that actually essentially mimics what quantum mechanics does, and then you're back to the same problem. So I think quantum mechanics, there's no way we can run with getting rid of quantum mechanics. Can you weaken gravity? Can you make the universe bigger? You know, can you make that horizon bigger? I think there's no reason why you couldn't have life in such a scenario. Can you get something like that from our fundamental theories? Again, maybe string theory, which has all these possible vacua, it will allow for these huge universes, which could maybe allow for room for Tree of Graham, or maybe Tree, okay, but something, one of these big numbers. So maybe there is place for them somewhere in the multiverse.
Just going back a couple of steps, you were talking about how the current universe hasn't got room for Tree of Graham. It's like, you know, it won't fit. That implies there is a highest possible number at the moment. Like, there is a limit. Like, at the moment, the numbers...
There's a data limit. There's absolutely... I mean, let's think of it in terms of data. We want to think of it in terms of things, or we want to think of it in, you know, in this nominalist sense. So let's quantify that with data. Okay. Yeah, absolutely. There's a data limit.
What is it? What's the highest possible number?
Oh, right.
Number?
Yeah.
Okay. How would you calculate it?
Oh, yeah. You have to calculate the entropy of the De Sitter. So this horizon, okay, it's given essentially by the area of that horizon in Planck units and units of Planck areas. So, you know, very, very tiny guys. Okay, so it's you're going to want me to calculate it, aren't you? I can probably do it quite quickly, actually.
Go on.
So I think it's so let's think about it. So it's it's going to be given by the entropy, okay, of this horizon. This horizon is how big is it? Its size is about a distance of about 1 over the Hubble, basically 1 over the Hubble parameter. So the area is going to scale, and it's going to scale like 1 over Hubble squared. Okay, and I need that in Planck units. Okay, so that's in L Plancks. Okay, so I need this, basically the size of this number. So this number, I think, let me just plug in the numbers. Okay, so this is, I think this is about 10 to the 26 meters. Sorry, no, so 10 to the 20, so the radius of the universe essentially is about 10 to the 26 meters, I think. I need to square that, and I think this is about 10 to the minus 30. The Planck length is about 10 to the minus 35 meters. Okay, so what's that going to come out as? So 10 to the 70 plus, I've got 10 to the 70 from below, I've got 10 to the 52. What's 70 plus 52? 122. It's that. It's not very big, is it?
That's the biggest possible number.
I think that's the cap on the... Let me just check I've done that right. Yeah, I think that's right. That sounds about right.
So when beyond using our imagination, which can take...
Beyond imagination, yeah. This is the cap on the data that you can have in our universe. Unless we're being tricked. It could be that we're being tricked, right? This is true if the vacuum energy of the universe is the value that I'm saying it should be, that's consistent with the data that we see. It could be that that's not the vacuum energy of the universe. That actually, the universe is going to, in the future, it's going to allow that horizon that surrounds us to grow, in which case, in principle, that number will go up. Okay, maybe the true number is actually much larger, but we just aren't really aware of it yet. But if, based on the data that we see, it seems that we're surrounded by this horizon, which is there because the universe, well, I mean, it's a future horizon as well. It's there, the universe is accelerating, and it's basically putting this cap on the amount of data that you can have in our universe.
Across, particularly when you start teaching this stuff, is that's crazy, right? So numbers exist outside space and time. What does that even mean, right? It's really, really hard to kind of get your head around.